Hi, this is your instructor, Julia Grav, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to create a decision support system that looks at growth rates, possible growth rates of a business that is both in the domestic realm and the foreign realm, and then a consolidated sheet that sort of looks at the combination of the domestic revenue and sales and costs and the foreign sales and costs. So follow along with the spreadsheet that I provided, and we are going to build this decision support system based off of these stats and assumptions. But we're going to start in the domestic sheet. So click into the domestic sheet, and you can see that it's already been set up with the labels that you need. Then we're going to perform some analysis here to calculate the annual increases and costs of this division. First thing we're going to do, however, is we're going to merge and center this title on both the foreign consolidated and domestic sheets. So we do this by grouping sheets. So if you take a look at these three sheets, they're all formatted in the same way. However, none of the titles here at the top are merged and centered, which when we do this, it helps us to see our data represented correctly. Grouping all the sheets by clicking and holding Control, we'll group them together. You can see here that they are now grouped. And then selecting the range that you want to merge the cells on. So I've just got B to F here in row one, and then clicking Merge and Center. And you can check the various sheets here now have been all merged and centered. We're going to use this grouping quite a bit on and off throughout this exercise to basically make it more efficient. These sheets have been set up specifically in the same way so that we can do 3D functions and cross fill functions across the sheets. So let's click off just by clicking on the summary sheet and then back to domestic. So here we're going to calculate our year one sales, costs, overhead, etc. based off of the assumptions data. So using the equals to, we're going to create references back to the summary data, and then in year two we are going to start the calculations assuming an increase. So into the summary sheet, the sales is going to be that first reference there, B3, and then I know that the other costs are just directly below that, so I can pull them in using the references by just dragging down, and we're going to check on that. So summary B6, yes, that is the overhead. The next line here, it requires for me to do a calculation. Other expenses is 10% of the sales. So back in the domestic sheet, I'm going to first the equal to, and now I'm going to reference this sheet B3 times back to the summary where we've got our reference to other expenses. Press enter. The net revenue is going to be the sales. So again, B3 minus the sum of all of our costs, overhead, and expenses. Now we're only going to be paying taxes if we actually make revenue. So we need an if statement here that will test for that and perform the necessary calculation. In this case, we can see here we've got a negative value, so it is not a positive revenue year, so we should expect zero. So if the net revenue is less than or equal to zero, we are going to put zero in this cell. Else, so our value is false, we're going to calculate the tax based off of this net revenue. So it would be the net revenue times the tax for the domestic here. And we're going to create an absolute function here because we're going to be copying this formula across. So we always want to reference this tax rate for the domestic value in this formula. So now we get zero, which has been formatted here. And then our revenue, even though we know that it's going to be the same as the net revenue, we're still going to perform the calculation because we're going to carry it across the sheet. It's going to be equal to our net revenue minus our taxes. Okay, let's build our year two assumptions based off of the summary data. I'm just going to zoom in so you can see the functions more clearly. So here we are, we're going to create a function here of the sales and the increase based off of our assumptions. But the first thing we're going to do is reference our sales from year one, and then we're going to times it by 1 plus the percentage increase. So closing the bracket, pressing enter, there is our function. And because this summary sheet has been set up perfectly, we can actually just copy down that function so that it gives us the values for the labor costs, material costs, and overhead. And then we'll pull over the other expenses function. So copying this down, let's check our references. So summary E6, I'm expecting that to be the percentage reference for the overhead increase. E6 is indeed, so I'm happy with that. And then other expenses, remember, we already created an absolute reference to the summary sheet. So we're going to pull that over, expecting the first reference there, to change from B3 to C3, sales in year two. The net revenue, we can also copy this function across. And our tax if statement, again, our net revenue is negative. So that makes sense, then we don't have to pay any taxes, and the revenue will be the same as the net revenue. So year 3, 4, and 5 are actually very easy to calculate here because we already have our functions set up. The only thing we need to do is create absolute references to all of the summary sheet references. So here, if we use F4 on the keyboard, we can change the reference to the sales increase to an absolute reference. So I'm going to do that for all of our summary sheet references in year two. And this one, of course, we pulled over from year one, so that's already an absolute. So now all of our functions here should be ready to be pulled across the remaining years of our domestic division. And there you have it. So now take a few minutes to calculate the foreign sheet, just as you did for this domestic sheet, and I'll meet you back here with the result, and we can compare those answers and check some of the functions to ensure that our data has integrity. Okay, once you get your year two calculations complete, remembering this time that we're using the assumptions for the foreign values, we want to make sure that we create absolute references to our summary sheet references so that we can pull this formula across through year 3, 4, and 5. Here we're just going to leave the regular references, and here as well we've got our if statement, and it already has an absolute reference to the tax for the foreign assumptions. So here, let's check that F7 in the summary sheet should indeed be the foreign tax rate. Let's finish this off by filling the data across year 5. Oh, we have an error. Let's see what it is. We've got an absolute reference here that's not absolute completely. Somehow I had a mixed reference there. So let's copy that across again. And now we can see that the values have updated, and this should be the final result. Finally, we're going to consolidate these sheets into one table that shows us both the domestic and the foreign costs and sales. So there's a couple ways we can do that. We can go to Data Consolidate is this little icon here. And if you're in a wider screen, you'll probably see actually the word consolidate, but it's basically multiple cells into one. So let's use that, and we're going to reference our domestic values, add that, and then we will reference our foreign values. My mouse seems to be playing some tricks on me. Okay, add, and then we're going to create links to source just so that if we change the data in any of those sheets, it will update our consolidation, and it will also create formulas in this sheet, which will be important when we create our data tables. So click OK. All right, so let's check that. 21,000 plus 95,000 is 116,000 thereabouts. Okay, So let's save. In addition to grouping, the consolidated data also has added in extra rows, which make it difficult to clear this data in order for us to do the 3D functions. But we can do it. Let's clear first all. So under the Home tab, clear all. That will remove the data in specifically the visible cells. If we go to the outline, we can see we've still got these additional rows here. So we can simply go through and delete those additional rows. It's a little time consuming. You can use Control to delete them all at once. Just being careful that you are keeping the same sort of structure. So there's one empty row between the tax and the final revenue. And we are going to clear the outline. And there we have it. We are ready to do the 3D functions. We can do it through linking or 3D formulas, right? Very easily. We can simply go equals to the domestic sales for year one plus the foreign sales for year one. And again, I'll zoom in there so that you can see all the values. And then because all these cells are stacked on top of each other, we can select the range and then fill across. It's simply a one value plus the other value, creating that consolidation. Now here we've got some unnecessary empty functions in there, so you can clean that up.